1952, Pittsburgh was soaring into the next half century with the grand dedication of its state-of-the-art $32 million air castle. 100,000 people joined Hollywood stars to marvel at this 20th century palace rising from pastureland. Over budget and behind schedule, the sprawling seven-story terminal, called the largest in the world, was said to have more curves than Mae West. Pittsburghers remember.
Oh, it just seems so big. That's all I can remember, being really big and vast.
Yes, I remember using the stairs to go on a D-plane, walk in through the rain, come in through the door right at ground level.
And they remember parking at Greater Pitt for only a quarter, when visiting the airport was considered an event, when Ted Lewis's band played in the Horizon Room, and for a dime you could take the kids to the observation deck for its sightseer's paradise.
It was great to go out there and watch, on a Sunday especially, watch some of the incoming, outgoing planes. Yes, it was sort of something to do on Sunday.
Skeptics called this aviation wonder too lavish and too remote, but people traveled from far and near just to see its black granite columns and marble balconies and escalators, the first ever in an airport.
Even back then, people suggested the idea of conveyor belts for passengers. But the idea seemed so futuristic in the early 50s that the county aviation director sarcastically replied in this news article that he would no sooner go for the installation of conveyor belts than he would a landing pad for flying saucers.
At least we're still waiting for the flying saucers. Sheila Hyland, WTAE 4 News.